Hello everyone, and thanks for watching this week's episode of Let's Read Together. And some people have asked me, Bart, where is it that you see all these life cycles of these Saturnidae that you read? Because I cannot find any information about them online. Well, there are some nice books that showcase the life cycle of some of a wide variety of species. And here you have one of those books for the Saturnidae lover. It's called The Saturnidae of the World, or in German, Pfauenspinner der Welt. The Life Stages from the Eggs to the Adult by Rudolf A.J. Lampe. It's a multilingual book, both in English and German. But let's take a look inside and you'll see why I can really recommend this work. So here we have the foreword. We'll skip through that, talking about just the basic wing venation of moths and close-ups, their internal structures. And this is where it really begins to hear starts to show its main feature, because this book contains the life cycle of many Saturnidae from egg to adult. As you can see, it has all the life stages, the eggs, all the larval instars, and even the adult male and female. And in this case, it's about the Coscinocera Hercules. But as we start looking through the book, it starts to become clear why this is one of my favorite books. Because it shows in detail the life cycle of many of these Saturnidae. If you've ever seen my website, it's similar to what I make on my website. Basically, a composition of the entire life cycle in captivity on the food plants. So I'm quickly going to go through the book. It's impossible to show you all the contents. Here you see some Opodiptera from Australia. And this is an African moth from the genus Vegetia. Now, all the species in this book are Saturnidae, okay? So this is really only for the people that study Saturnidae. For example, here we see Vegetia lewitzi, one of my favorite species. Holocerina, Ludinae. And here we see even the elusive caterpillar of Orthogonioptilum, one of the very few pictures that exist of the larval form of this moth. In fact, most of the caterpillars of Orthogonioptilum are still unrecorded to science. Here we see Degagorda, again from egg, caterpillar, cocoon, adult, a very tiny Saturnid moth from Africa that feeds on grasses. Anterina suraca, African moon moths. Now, as I start going through the book, you'll notice that what you currently see is everything that you're going to get, because the book consists of almost 100% life cycle compositions. For example, here, one beautiful Epiphora with blue larva, Epiphora, Epiphora, Pseudanthera, Melanocera. Here even the Eogroa trimeni, one of my dream species. It's only found in Namaka land, which is an area that overlaps South Africa and Namibia. Gonimbrasias, Ubuena, Pseudobunea. And it just goes on and on. Now, the Saturnidae in this book, they are sorted by fauna region, which means that first you'll see the African species, the American species, the Asian species. All of them are basically sorted by geographical region and not by alphabetical, which makes sense because that's exactly the way that museums do it, usually sorting things by fauna region, ecological geographic region. And this book has hundreds of pages, so I'm going through them really fast. Otherwise, it would be impossible to show you the contents of all this. In fact, I'm turning multiple pages at once. For example, here we see Heneuga Apollonia. If you're a YouTube fan of mine, you've seen this one before. Aurifilius. Here we start to go to the American species. We see the genus Ciceronia, one of my favorites. My channel even has a special playlist about them, so you'll probably remember them. Aeacles, which are part of the same subfamily as Ciceronia, so we are currently looking at the Ceratocampinae. Sisphinx, Automeres. Automeres, I imagine this is going to be, when we get to all the Automeres species, you're going to get many pages of content, because that's one huge genus. We are currently in North America, as you can see. Antirrhea oculea, Antirrhea polyphemus, Colossamia, Hyalophora, Arsenurinae, which are found in South America. And as you can see, this book is has been a lot of effort. It's basically the collective effort of many people who had to send in pictures of their rearing and life cycles. So there's several breeders across the world who are working on this to reveal the life cycle of all these Ciceronia. And I'm going to go faster now because we're not even, as you can see, halfway. Ciceronia, Ciceronia. So many species. Now, family Saturninae, here's one of my favorites, Neocarnegia. Saturninae is a big family, so you imagine it's a big book. Here we see, for example, Lonomia, Assassin Caterpillar, that sounds very edgy. Automeres Janus, Automeres Metzli, yep. Oh, we are currently at Automeres, so we're going to skip through the Automeres because there's so many of them. Hundreds and hundreds of species. And it's a great referential material. The only downside of this book is that even though it's a very big book, contains a lot of images, it does not list many and the majority of the Saturninae species. And the reason for that is because the Saturninae family is basically too big to put into one book. So it probably contains the most common species here. But if you want to see the life cycle of the most common regular species here, you're probably going to find them in here. If you want to see the life cycle of more obscure species, then you're not going to find them in here. But I think this covers the majority. Currently we are at Rothschildia. And this book is just amazing. As you can see, we're at the Atlas moth now. Attacus lorcini, Attacus erebus. From Sulawesi, Argeotacus stauderingi, Argeotacus edwardsi. You can even see the differences. Samia. I really can highly recommend this book to everyone that's interested in silk moths like I am. Actias rhodopneuma. With some luck, we're going to see this one alive on my channel someday. I still cannot find anyone who will sell me cocoons and eggs of this one. Leupa. Yes, that's pronounced Leupa. Rodinia, Saturnia, aka and Caligula, Cricula. So, I'm going to go through the last pages fast because you probably got the idea by now and I don't have to show off you the entire book. But just to get through all the content. Neoris, Antireas, Actias. And at the end, we get some nice indexes and host plant recommendations, and that's it. Thanks for watching. This was Bart with Saturninae of the World. The internet is so useful, but still a good biologist is nothing without his field guides and books. If you want to read a new novel, there are probably hundreds of reviews waiting for you online. But if you are into things like this, then it's probably hard for you to find reviews. So thanks for watching my mini series on YouTube called Let's Read Together,
where I review books, field guides that focus on biology, nature, and my study of insects. I don't expect this series to get millions of views because it's such a peculiar thing. But that's the great thing about it. It's easy to find reviews of popular books, but I'm one of the few people who showcase things like this. Now, if you like this concept, please consider liking this video, subscribing to my channel, and consider joining my crowdfunding platform, Patreon. Because for some reason, YouTube has decided to demonetize my channel. So I am dependent on crowdfunding for 100% in order to support this channel and upgrade the production quality. If I got 1 million subscribers tomorrow, it wouldn't make a difference for me. What counts is the people that support me. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next episode.